A very good morning to all my dear students. In this class, we will discuss about one monocotyledons family of large medicinal values. Many species belonging to this family have been widely used as spice or flavoring agents due to its aromatic odor, pungent and spicy taste, and also essential oil used in the perfume industry. This family plants are characterized by the presence of volatile oil and oleoresins. When I call the name of one drug, you certainly answer which is this monocotyledonous family. Ginger. Yes, the family name is Zingiberaceae. In this topic, we will discuss about diagnostic, vegetative, floral characters and medicinal importance of Zingiberaceae family. Common name of the family is Zingiber family or Ginger family. I already said that many species are economically valuable for their spices and perfumes. The dried thick rhizomes of curcuma longa is called turmeric, which is a very popular antiseptic, antimicrobial, liver tonic and anti-cancerous drug. The seeds of Eleuteria cardamomum, which is a very popular spice called as queen or spice, is a source of cardamom. Ginger is obtained from the rhizome of Zingiber officinae, which is a very expectorant carminative drug. Several species of Alpinia are used as ornamental and also have very most medicinal values. Ginger lily is also called hedicium. It produces beautiful flowers that are used in garlands and other decorations. Now, let us go through the systematic position of the family. Class is monocotyledon, series is epigynae. There is no subclass and orders in this family. What are the characters of the monocotyledonae? Yes, it consists of only one cotyledon, parallel venation of leaves, fibrous root system, closed and scattered vascular bundles. Closed means the vascular bundles are closed to secondary growth because of the absence of cambial rings, and also the vascular bundles are scattered in monocotyledonous plants. Then series is epigynae. In epigynae series, the flowers are epigynous, that is the ovary is inferior in position, and it consists of two whorls of perianth, and inner whorl of the perianth is petaloid, and the seeds are endospermic. Its endospermic means the seeds which contains endosperms, which is a nutritive tissue. There are common particular characters are found in each family, and that characters are called diagnostic features or diagnostic characters. Thus, in Zingiberaceae family, the diagnostic features which includes the presence of aromatic oils, ligules, marked differentiation of perianth into calyx and corolla, single stamens, and largely usually petaloid, staminodium or labellum. So, you know that the plants which contain the aromatic oils, and these aromatic oils are abundant in rhizomes and it's much smaller amount in other radial parts. And the aromatic oil is present in special secretory ducts called the lysigenous ducts or schizogenous ducts. The next character is the ligule. Ligules are the narrow, thin, strap-shaped or finger-shaped membranous scales on the inner side of the leaf sheath is called the ligule, or it may be found at between the leaf sheath and also in between the leaf lamina. That particular membranous structure is called the ligule, which is a characteristic feature of this family. Then we already stated that there is a differentiation of calyx and corolla, that perianth lobes are present and these are differentiated into calyx and corolla. Then single stamen. In Zingiberaceae, there are six stamens and these are arranged in two whorls. And the innermost posterior stamen only is fertile stamen and other all stamens are sterile. And the inner side of the stamens, in which only one fertile stamens are present, but the other two stamens are united to form a petaloid beautiful structure is called the staminodium or labellum, which is a sterile stamen. Common plants of Zingiberaceae are Zingiber officinale, Curcuma longa, Curcuma aromatica, Curcuma amida, Curcuma caesia, Curcuma sedoaria, Curcuma angustifolia, Alpinia galanga, Alpinia officinarum, Alpinia calcareta, Camphidia galanga, Camphidia rotunda, Eleteria cardamomum, Amomum subulatum, Costus speciosus, Costus pictus, Hedicium coronarium, and Hedicium spicatum. General features and habitat. Next is the vegetative characters. First is the habit. The plants are perennial herbs with creeping horizontal or tuberous underground stems called rhizomes. I sure that you have a thorough knowledge about rhizomes. And the most of them are aromatic due to the presence of aromatic depths. Most of the plants are aromatic, and this aromaticity is due to the presence of aromatic depths, that is, it's maybe lysigenous depths or schizogenous depths. Root consists of adventitious roots arise from the rhizomes, rarely fibrous. You know that the adventitious roots are the roots which arising from any other parts other than the root. It's arising from anywhere except roots, that is called the adventitious roots. And in some cases, the roots tip are swollen due to the presence of reserve food materials. So that examples are the Curcuma amida is a mango ginger, and the Camphidia rotunda is called the Chengadunir kiranga or crocus, Indian crocus, that is the Camphidia rotunda. Stem consists of underground stems and also aerial stems. Aerial stems are very short and reduced, and the underground stems, that is called the rhizomes. And there is a aerial stems which are scapos, that is, it have the long internode and also leafy. So the leaves are the stems consist of the rhizome and the stems are very short. In sometimes we can see the aerial parts which consists of the long stems. This is not actually known as stems, it's a called as pseudo stems, because the leaves are rolled up along with their leaf sheath, forming a stems like structure that's called the pseudostem. So the characters are the rhizome, and it is the underground structure, and the aerial stems which are very short, and sometimes it may be the elongated, and that's called the scapos, and the stems are very leafy, and also pseudostems are present. The leaves are radical or halline. Radical means the leaves directly arising from the base of the stems or from the ground stem, that is called the radical leaf. And the leaves are estipulate and also distichous, that is, the leaves are alternately arranged, but the in distichous leaf, the third leaf, which is just opposite to the first leaf, that type of arrangement is called distichous leaf. And the leaves are petiolate or sometimes sessile. Then sheathing leaf bases, which is the important characteristics of this family. The base of the leaves which surrounds the stems, and there is a leaf sheath is present, that's called the sheathing leaf bases. Then ligulate, we already explained that what is a ligule. Then spiral type of leaves in costus, and these leaves are simple, entire, elliptical, linear or lanceolate, and the apex is acute or obtuse. And another character is the parallel venation, which is the characteristic feature of the monocotyledonous. Vegetative characters are over. The next is the floral characters. Inflorescence consists of terminal spike, racemos or panicle, and it is in Curcuma species. The spike, the inflorescence is spike, and it is terminating in a cone. It is cone-like in Curcuma species and also in Zingiber, ginger. In Alpinia, the inflorescence is racemose type, and also it is spike. Flowers are bracteate, and the bracts are very large and conspicuous in ginger, turmeric and also Alpinia. And in ginger, the bract is persistent, and also in Curcuma, the bract is persistent. It is coriaceous in Hedicium. In Alpinia, the bracts are variously colored, and because of this variability in colors is the alpinia species are of great ornamental values. Then flowers are pedicellate or sessile, complete, that is all floral whorls are present, zygomorphic, bisexual, epigynous, cyclic. Flowers are large sized and also beautifully colored and also trimerous. And the perianth lobe is differentiated into two whorls, that is the outermost herbaceous or membranous three lobed calyx, and it may be the spathaceous or tubular, and the petaloid tubular corolla, and also it's with the three lobes, so it is trimerous. Calyx consists of three sepals, gamosepals, tubular, cylindrical or spathe like shape, generally three toothed, green, and odd sepal is anterior. Corolla also consists of three petals, gamopetalous. The shape of the corolla may be varied. It may be tubular, funnel shaped or three lobed, and lobes are unequal, linear or broad. I already told that the andrisium consists of how many stamens? It consists of six stamens, and they are arranged in two whorls. The outer whorl usually suppressed or absent or become staminodes. The posterior stamens of the inner whorl is fertile or which is epipetalous and also antipetalous. That is, only one fertile stamen is present and they are positioned as posterior in position, and also it is the inner whorl of the six stamens. The other two lateral stamens of the inner whorl, I tell you about the stamens regarding the inner whorl. The other two lateral stamens of the inner whorl are sterile and are mostly petaloid and are fused together to form a petaloid lip or labellum or staminodium. So when we go through its flower structure, we are certainly confused with the petaloid structure, which is a petal, but it's not actually a petal. It is a staminodes, which is the attractive part of the flower. The connective of the anther, which produces certain appendages like structure in most cases, and it may be the spur, that is, it consists of the tubular projections, for example in Zingiber and also in curcuma. Then the connective sometimes may be the grooved, and the style of the gynecium is passing through this groove. Then anthers are bithecous and also the hives by longitudinal slits. Gynecium consists of three carpels, tricarpellary, syncarpous, inferior, trilocular, with many ovules on axial placentation. Styles are long, thin, stigma, simple or funnel shaped or bilipped, and also ciliate, sometimes it may be globose. Two nectariferous discs present at above the epigynous ovary. In some genus, especially in Alpinia, the single style is passing through the connective, that is the groove of the connective of fertile stamen, and the stigma seen beyond the anther lobes. The fruit is a loculicidal capsule opening by three valves. Loculicidal capsule is a fruit which is a dry dehiscent fruit developed from multicarpellary ovary, which dehisces through the locules. The seeds are endospermic, and in cardamom the seeds are aromatic. Regarding the medicinal importance of Zingiberaceae, we already studied these drugs under pharmacognosy part as organized drugs as rhizomes, and just go through the slides and study the important chemical constituents and pharmacological actions and also medicinal uses. Okay, thank you.